Hi, this is Larry Jordan. This is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything, where I get to answer questions from viewers. For instance, this one. Oh, Bill Rabkin asks, in Final Cut 10, when a title is selected, often the Kerning option is grayed out. How come? Letter spacing affects the spacing of all the letters in a line. Kerning affects the spacing between two selected letters. Let me show you. Let's say that I want to put a title over this. Control T to add a title. Razor blade to cut it. We'll just cut the title here and delete it. Shift Z to get it to fit. And I'll double click the title. There it is. When I'm working with titles, although it is possible to select the title and move it on the screen, most of the time I don't, because it gets really, really hard to select that text. So I'm going to just add Larry's title here. And we can grab the white circle and drag it over so we can put the title wherever we want. But I tend to want to go to the inspector, click the text tab, and select the text inside the text box. This allows me to be really clear on what I'm selecting. At that point, I can then change it and make it whatever font I want, for instance, Impact. And I can make it whatever size I want to make it big enough to see what's going on. Now, let's change Larry's title to Larry's AV. Let's make it WA title. Okay. In the text box, I put my cursor between the letters W and A, and notice when I do, the Kerning lights up. Kerning allows me to move my letters that are on either side of the cursor closer or farther apart. What letter spacing allows me to do is letter spacing, also called tracking, allows me to move all the letters on the line closer or farther apart. Kerning always affects just two characters on either side of the cursor. Now here in a font like Impact, the kerning is minimal because the letters are so thick and they're designed to work well together. In other fonts, for instance, the letter T and the letter I, or the letter T and any other letter, V, all right, let's just set this to a different font here. Let's try this one. There we go. Notice how it could be argued that the T and the V are too far apart. It feels like they should be tucked in a little bit tighter. So again, taking my kerning and pulling this together, I can overlap the two characters. But in order for that to work, my cursor has to be between the two characters. If nothing is selected, the kerning is grayed out. This was an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything. For a complete list of all of our online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. Oh, by the way, membership is a great value. If you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 500 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and up-to-date. Plus, members can attend all of our power-up webinars for free. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. Thanks.